So we'll start with the functions again. A lot of things has to be done in the functions, but before going with the functions, let's do some small basic stuffs. So one of the basic stuff is exponent literals. So what is exponent literal? These are the numbers, but they are written in a different way. So for example, I will write 1, then I will say e1. When I say 1 e1, it converts into 10, because this 1 will be 1 and this e1 is kind of 10. We are multiplying it with 10. So I can write 1 e plus 1 also. Not like this. 1 e plus 1. Okay, so I can write 1 e plus 1 like this. I cannot give the space kind of thing like this. This is not right. So I can give 1 e plus 1, or I can say 1 e 1. It will both result into the same value. Since it is saying e plus 1, that is the reason I am giving, multiplying it by 10. So for example, if it is 2 e plus 3, so it will give me 2000. This e plus 3, if 3 is there, we have to give 3 zeros. So we have to give 3 zeros. So if there is, let's say, 4 e plus 8, that means we have to give 8 zeros after this 4 number. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we are giving 8 zeros that are multiplying with, this number. Maybe you can say 1 with 8 zero. Okay, so we are multiplying with this number, or we are extending the zero to the number before the e. That is what exponent literal means. So let's take few examples of exponent literals. So if I say, again, I'll put 1 e plus 1. I cannot give space because that becomes a normal JavaScript. If I want exponent literal, I will give 1 e plus 1. So let's say I give 2 e plus 3. That means after 2, I will add 3 zeros to it. And if I want to see the type of, so type of 2 e plus 3 is a number. So this part is number. We can call this as a number. This is not a string, this is not a boolean, this is a number. So 2 e plus 3 means 3 times, decimal is moved 3 times to the right. So if I have 2 number, decimal, 2 number means 2.0. So decimal will move 3 times to the right. So we have 1, 2, 3. So if it is 2 e plus 3, that means decimal will move 3 times to the right. If I have 2 e plus 4, that means decimal is moved to the 4 digit to the right. So we have to put extra zeros here before that decimal. Now what happened in the case of going to the left side? So for example, if I have 2 e minus 3. So when I say 2 e minus 3, that means I have the 2 number and decimal is moved 3 digit to the left side. So it will be 1, 2, total 3 digit, and I put 0. So that means 0, 0, 2 will be here, and I have dot, this is the 3 digit. Okay, so this is what 2 e minus 3 or 2 e plus 3 means. Now let's take one more example. I will say 123.456 e minus 3. So I want you to answer this question. So I'm not putting the answer, exact question. Otherwise, it will give the answer immediately. So I will put it here, and I want you to find out what will be the answer of this one. So I have 123.456 e minus 3. What will be the answer of this? See, this is the minus sign. That means dot will move to the left side. So Anand has written 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That is, it is moving to the right side. It should move to the left side. If it is minus, the amount will be reduced. So it will go to 0.123456. Yeah. Yes, Dusty, Anand, Nikhil, all are correct now. Right. So this is the exponent literal. Many times we will be using E, and that will make our life simpler. Rather than putting 10 0, I can say E plus 10. So if it is 1 with 10 0, I can say 1 E plus 10. So that means it has 1, and after that it is a 10 zeros after that. So this is called about the exponential literal. Okay, let me give you the notes for that one. You can check it later whenever you have time. You want to. So I'll put that in the chat, the notes for this one. I'll also put in the Telegram. Okay, let's move further now. We have seen the exponent literal. Let's check the infinity. So let's check the infinity. So there is a special value in JavaScript, and that value is called infinity. So if a number is very big for JavaScript to handle, it becomes an infinity. So infinity is a number. So if I put type of infinity, it is a number. Okay, and what consists of the infinity, we'll see in a bit. So let me put first infinity. Infinity, if I put, the answer is coming infinity. So the value of infinity is infinity. Now if I want to see the type of infinity, what is the infinity, whether it's a string or whether it's a boolean, so it is saying type is number. The infinity type is number. Okay, so now what is the value of infinity? So highest value. So if I type, so if I have 1e plus 308, this number is finite. That means if I put 3080 after the 1, then also it becomes finite in JavaScript. Let's see what happens if I put 309, 1e plus 309. So if I put 1e plus 309, it becomes immediately infinity, because it goes beyond the scope of the JavaScript. So if we have 309 zeros after 1, it becomes infinite number. Okay, and the smallest number which JavaScript consider is 5e minus 324. So below this it will be minus infinity, and above this it will be plus infinity. So if I say 1e plus 308, it is coming correctly, right? So if I divide any number, okay, for example, var a equal to 6 divided by 0. So you have seen in the mathematics, if anything we divide by 0, it goes to the infinite number. And so if I see what is the value of a is the infinity. Because anything divided by 0, it is represented by infinity. So infinity is the biggest number, and minus infinity is the smallest number. So if I choose I is equal to minus infinity, and then I say type of I, it's a number, and I value of I is minus infinity. So what will happen if I take the infinity and minus with infinity? So if I do infinity minus infinity, it becomes a not a number. It becomes a value which is not a number. So we consider this as a not a number. So what will happen if I minus some number from the infinity, for example 100? So if I minus anything from the infinity, the answer is also infinity, because infinity is beyond the terms, beyond the limit of our calculation. So it goes to, so anything we minus infinity, it becomes infinity. So what happen if I multiply by some number, infinity into 3? It's going infinity. If I take minus infinity into something, it goes into minus infinity side. And if I take infinity and if I minus with some big number, then also the answer will become infinity. So anything we minus or multiply, it becomes infinity. Okay, or divide also, it becomes infinity. For example, infinity divided by 3. So answer is 3. So anything divide, multiply, or plus or minus, the answer always goes to infinity or minus infinity, depending on what you are using, infinity or not infinity. So this is a short description on the infinity. So we may come up something about infinity. So we should know what is the infinity. So there is also one term in JavaScript that is called not a number. It's called not a number, N-A-N, like this. So if something we cannot calculate as a number, then it becomes not a number. And we use this not a number many times in our programming to know if it is a numeric value or it's not a numeric value. Okay, so for example, if I see type of not a number is a number. It's a new number, but type is number, but it does not consist any numeric value. Okay, so for example, if I take bar a equal to not a number, and a is not a number. So whenever we add, for example, 1 plus 2 plus n not a number, so answer will come not a number. Because this addition of not a number to a number becomes not a number. So many times if we want to check if a number is there, if number exists, so I always check with the not a number value. And if NaN is true, that means it is not a number. And if NaN is not true, then it becomes a number. So this way we check if the particular value is a number or not. Okay, this is the short introduction about the not a number. Let's do one more thing before we jump to the functions. Okay, undefined and null. So let's see the difference between undefined and null. So if I write a variable which does not exist, for example, foo. So I did not create that variable. So it is saying foo is not defined and it gives an error kind of thing. So we should have that variable already in our system before we write it. Otherwise, we will get error in it. So if I say type of foo is undefined because we haven't defined it. Therefore, type of foo is undefined. Even if I define something, for example, bar. So what is the value of bar? Undefined. Whenever we create a variable in JavaScript without any value, it is by default gets the value of undefined. Otherwise, if I say some value 2, then value of boo is 2. Here I am defining variable with the value of 2. And that is the reason I am getting the value 2. But if I define a variable without any value, it is by default undefined. I can create a variable x equal to null, and then value of x will become null, and the null is type of null is object. So if I say type of x is object, because null is a value, a special value, and it has a value, it is a type of object. Now whenever you create a variable, you never do like this bar equal to undefined. Never do a variable and assign its value to undefined. This undefined is defaultly created by JavaScript and assigned to the variable whenever a variable is created without any value. So manually we should never define a variable to be undefined. So for example, you have variable bar equal to 2, and tomorrow you want to make it undefined. You don't do bar equal to undefined. Never ever do bar equal to undefined. So you will never make the value undefined. You can make the value as 0 or null or empty string if it is a string, but never make it undefined. So better is to make it null. So whenever your program will run and it will see the value is null, that means you have created that value null. But whenever the program will run and you will see the value undefined, you will know that undefined is created by JavaScript and you have not made it undefined. So in that way, you will know if you have manually changed it to null or it is by default undefined by the system. So always remember, whenever we want to do undefined, or whenever we want to make empty, the value empty, we always make it null, not the undefined. Undefined is only done by the JavaScript engine and it should not be done manually. So let's take some example of a null kind of thing. So for example, if I have variable I equal to 1 plus undefined, if I add 1 with undefined, the value will become not a number, because 1 is a number and this is undefined. So JavaScript cannot determine if it's a number or not. So final 1 will become not a number. But what happened with var I equal to 1 plus null? So if I make it null, 1 plus null, then JavaScript converts this null to 0 and the value of I will become 1. So if I say I now, so answer will become 1. So JavaScript is able to convert this null into 0 kind of thing in the numeric conversion, and so we are getting the value of 1, that is this one, 1 plus 0 is 1. But JavaScript cannot convert undefined to 0, so we are getting not a number in this case. So this is the difference between undefined and null. So if we have something null, JavaScript will convert it to 0 and we will get the answer of 1. So what will happen if I multiply anything with undefined? So if I multiply 1 by undefined, it is giving not a number. But what will happen if I multiply with null? So it will give 0, because null is converted to 0 by JavaScript, and when I multiply with anything, it will become 0. Okay, so this is a minute difference between undefined and null. I will give you notes after this session of this all things. So we have seen one more thing. We have seen I create, if I want to see the global variables, I will use this. And in this, I can see all the global variables like A is there, boo is there, bar is there. All the variables are there, plus default variables created by JavaScript are also there. So what will happen if I create a variable without any var? For example, I'm creating a variable sys equal to 10. What you will think, whether it will be global variable or whether it will be local variable or what? So I want to create a variable sys equal to 10. So Anand is saying global. Okay, let's do a little more study on that one. So if I created a function a and I will say sys equal to 1. Okay, I created this function. What will happen if I type sys now? whether it will give me 1 or whether it will give me error or what will happen, or whether it will be give me undefined. Okay, so if I run sys, it will give me error because though I have defined A, though I have defined sys inside the function, but I have not called the function. Since I have not called the function, JavaScript does not know that this exists anywhere in the system. This will not go and hoist unless I will call the A function. Now what will happen if I call the A function? Now whether the sys will be the local to this function or it will be global. Since I have written sys inside the function, so Uday is saying local, Ola is saying local, Yes is saying local. I want more answers. Sonu is saying local. What else? Nikhil. Ali, Nikhil. I want answers from everybody. Gautami. Where are your answers? Where is Nikhil? How is saying local? Okay. So remember one thing. If I create a variable without the var sign, then it is not local. It is global. So this sys will be the global. So if I say sys, it is giving 1 because I run sys after I call the function A. But if I go to this function, this object, you will see So this is here in the global object. Okay, so that means if I create a variable, even if it is inside the function, but the variable is without the var. So if I create one variable sys1 equal to 1, if I create another variable sys2 without the var sign, then sys1 is the local variable to this B, but sys2 is the global variable. So if I run B and if I go this, so you will see sys is there, which we created some time back. Sys2 is also there with the value of 4, but sys1 is not there because sys1 is local to that function and this is the global object. So we are not able to see the sys1, and sys1 is only available in this function. It is not available globally, but sys2 is available in the globally because we created sys2 without the var sign. Okay, now what will happen if I try to delete the sys2? Let's try to delete the sys2. Okay, let's create another one. Let me create another tab so I can show you the delete part. So I will create one variable A equal to 1. I will create another variable B or function B. And here I will create var C equal to 2. And I'll set D equal to 3. And after that I will call the B function so that this D should be in the global space. Now I create another variable E equal to 4. Now tell me whether A is a global variable, local variable. Uday is saying local. Since A is outside the function, A is a global variable. Whether C is a global variable, local variable. C C is the local variable because it is created with the var sign and it is inside the function. Since it is inside the function, so C is local to this function. Okay. Now tell me whether D is a local or global variable. Global. Since D is created inside the function, but it is created without the var sign. Since it is created without the var sign, so D is a global variable. Now tell me, E is a global variable or local variable? E is a global variable because it is created without the var sign. If we create a variable without the var sign, anywhere in the function or outside, it is always the global variable. Okay, let's see the this value. If I see the this, I will have A, which I created here. I have the B, which I created here. I don't see C because C is a local variable, but I see D because D is a global variable, and I will also see E because E is a global variable. Okay. So now I will try to delete the variables. Let me try to delete the variable first A. I will try to delete A variable. So I will say delete A. So what it is saying? False. That means it is not able to delete the variable A. And if I run this again, I will be able to see A here. Now let me try to delete C. It is local variable. It should not be accessible outside the function. Okay, so if something, actually C is does not exist at the global level, so it is giving true because it does not exist on the global level. So since it is not there, so it is deleting anything which is not there, it is always giving true. Since anyhow C is not in the global scope, but C is in the function scope, so it can be accessed inside the function but not globally. So if I put some variable name which does not exist, then JavaScript always give true if it is does not exist. Now what will happen if I delete D? I saw that when I delete A, it is not deleting because it is created with the var. Let's try to delete D. So it is saying true. So let me see this again. If I see the this, I am not able to find the D because D is deleted. And confirmation is here, I get true. So anything which is created without the var can be deleted, but anything which is created with the var cannot be deleted. So whether I can delete E or no, yes or no. If I want to delete E, whether I will be able to delete E or no? Yes, because E is created without the var, but I am not able to delete var A equal to 1. Because A is created with the var. Let's go through it little bit more. If I have var x equal to 1, var y equal to 2, z equal to 3. Whether I will be able to delete x, yes or no? No, because it is created with the var. Whether I will be able to delete y or yes or no? No, because it is created with the var. Whether I will be able to delete z or no? Yes, because it is created without var. That is true. Now let's move this to object. I create one object with the var keyword and I will name it ABC and I will say last name XYZ. I will say age 31. Okay, so some error. I cannot put semicolon here. Okay, so I got one object. Whether I will be able to delete object, yes or no? No, because it is created with the var keyword. So if I try to delete object, it will give me false. That means it cannot delete it. But if I try to delete, if I want to see object, it is name, last name, age. But if I try to delete object dot name, whether I will be able to delete, yes or no? So everybody is saying yes, one is saying no, Uday is saying no. So if I say this one, answer is coming true, and if I am checking object, it is name is deleted. So though object is, I am not able to delete this object because it is created with the var, but all the variables inside this object, they are not created with the var. Though main object is created with the var, but inside them it is not created with the var, and inside them whatever the variable are there, they are attached to this object, and we can delete this any variable inside it. So though no matter it is initially created with the var, all inside item can be deleted with the delete statement. So if I want to delete last name, sorry, obj dot last name, it is true, and if I run obj, it is giving age. If I try to delete obj dot age, it is coming true, and obj is saying empty object. So this is about the deletion. So remember one thing, though I create variable without var and it is created in the global space, never try to create variable without the var sign. So you should always use var equal to whatever you have. Never ever try to create without var, because if you try to create with the var, you won't be able to track it properly. If you have a very big script and you want to go from one place to another, then anything which is without var is difficult to track, and it will give unknown errors to you which you will be not able to fix it. So always create with some var. I just showed things that what is possible in JavaScript, but never ever create variable without var. Never ever create variable without var sign. Okay, so this is the short outcome of what we did it. Now I will start a very basic of function today, and more we will do tomorrow, day after tomorrow, and it's a very big topic. It may go 3-4 lectures or 5-6 lectures to complete these functions. So today I will only do 5 minutes more about the functions, and then we are done for today. So first is, what is a function? So function is something, function is grouping of code. So we group together the code and we call the group together, and that is called function. And we can reuse it again and again. So for example, if I create a function sum with A and B, and it has few lines of the code, for example, var C equal to A plus B, and then it will return C. So it has few lines of the code grouped together. This is a grouping, and it can be called again and again by calling this function name, and then a whole piece of code will run together. So that is the simple function means. Now what are the parts of the functions? So one part is the function statement. Okay, that function statement is this function statement, function. Second thing is name, name of the function. So what is the name of the function here? It is the sum. What is the third thing of the function? It is a parameters. Now what are the parameters here? A and B. A and B. And what is the fourth part of the function? It's a code block. So what is the code block? This is the code block. From this curly bracket to this curly bracket, this is the code block, and it should always have a return value. If you don't put return, then it will return undefined. So whenever we call this function, and if we don't see the return, the default return is undefined. So it is better, you should always return something, whatever you want. But sometimes, you know, function does not return anything. you don't want to return anything. You just want to console.log something. You don't want to return any value. Then it will return undefined. So return is there even though you return it manually or not. If you don't put return statement here, then by default, JavaScript will return undefined. So this is by default return from the function. So return is always there. If you write your return, it will be your return. If you don't write it, JavaScript will return undefined. So you should always return something. And in function, you can only return one value. You cannot return like this. You cannot return C, A, B. You cannot return like this. You can return only one value like this. What if I want to return multiple values? If I want to return multiple values, I can either create array and return it, or I can create a object and return it, like C is C, A is A, B is B. So I can return either object with multiple values, or I can return with array. So function can return only one value, but if you want to return multiple values, you can use array or object, whatever you like. So if I created a function, let me create this one again. If you have created a function, if I write only the sum, what will it showing? It is showing the code block. It is showing the code block which we have in the sum. It is not running the function. It is not invoking the function. It is only showing the code block which we have for the sum. But if we want to invoke, or if we want to call, or if we want to run the sum, then I have to run the sum with a parenthesis. And here I will pass the value, whatever value I want to pass. So here I'm passing sum 2, 3, and I'm getting the return value, which is C. That is addition of this. So if I write something, only sum without parenthesis, it will give me the code block. But if I run or invoke the function by parenthesis, then it will give the value. Okay, so this is the short about the calling the function. And these are called the parameters. As I already explained to you, these are the parameters. But when I call this sum with 2 and 6 value, this 2 and 6 is called arguments. So I'm passing 2 and 6. This 2 and 6 is called arguments. When we call the function, then the value which we pass here is called arguments. But when we create the function and we have same this parameters, this A and B is called parameters. So there's difference between parameters and argument. When we call the function, it is argument. When we create the function, it is parameters. Okay, this is short about the function definition. One more thing to remember about the function. If I create a function, sum A, B, and if I do console.log, and here I say arguments. So if I call this function with 1 and 2, you will see I get this arguments as an object. It's an array, but a special kind of object, because it has some more functions in it. So it is not really the array, but it is not really the object also. So it is a special type of object which looks like array. So the first value which I am passing is 0, and the second value which I am passing is 2. So if you don't know how many arguments are passed, with the keyword of arguments, you can get all the arguments of the function. So this is the addition in JavaScript, you can check. And that's all for today. We will do more about this tomorrow, all about the functions in the detail, which will help you to understand function in a better way and how the JavaScript handles a function. JavaScript handles a function in completely different way than other programming language. And we have to see what are the things JavaScript do when invoking the function or when defining the function. And that we will see in few lectures today, tomorrow, day after tomorrow, and next week. Any questions?